Guys, my name is Dave and welcome to another video. So, I think it's high time I talked about something that, or revisit a topic of something that, of importance that I have not discussed in a while. Originally this discussion was dedicated to be like a once a year thing, but recent events kind of caused me to rethink through that and make an exception. So, today I'm going to be talking about something that I believe at the beginning of every year for the past couple of years I've been working at trying to talk about. And that is just that of words of comfort and support. And the reason for the time that for me talking about it this time is actually someone who is a coworker of Pink Fox's and mine, and someone who we can at least consider a friend. I'm not going to give a name or anything like that just for the sake of confidentiality, but I will say that this person has been going through a lot recently. Whether at work or not, her life has been kind of overloaded in a way. And she's been going through a lot more than she feels like she can handle. In a way, I've been in that kind of position before. Not in the exact same state, but I understand the mindset of feeling overwhelmed to the point where it just feels like life is kicking you in the butt way too much. Now, with what circumstances are actually going on, Pink Fox could probably relate a bit more to what this person is dealing with, because she's actually had the situations dealt to her before. And well, I haven't. But the one thing I do have is at least the capability of understanding that everyone has their own level of crap they have to deal with, and for some people it's worse than others. And the worst that I've ever had to go through had pushed my limits to a point where I could not handle. It was for a different reason than a lot of other people, but I think for me specifically, at the point in time I'm referring to, I don't know how to deal with depression. And it hit me hard at one point, and because of that factor, I didn't know how to deal with it, so my response was very, very, very large. With this particular person, though, it's not just simply depression. And I use simply very faintly, because that doesn't even begin to describe it. Now, once again, it's a confidential thing, so I'm not going to go into detail about what's going on. It is not my place to say. It is not my place to tell. But it is my place to say that whenever it comes down to it, and I've said this before on the channel, when there's a specific level of negativeness or darkness, I guess you could say, there will be somewhere an equivalent level of light. just have to look. And sometimes that can be very difficult to do if you're under certain circumstances. That's why I kind of make these kind of videos every now and then. It's because a lot of people struggle to do that. And it's more of a reiteration to let those individuals know, especially if they cross paths with this channel, that they're not alone. That there's always at least one person willing to listen. Even if you don't know it yet. A couple of years ago, before I met Amber, this is something I had a hard time believing. I thought that it was hard for me to believe that that kind of thing was out there. And I'm not including, like, parents or siblings or stuff like that, because, yeah, they're always there, but that level of understanding isn't always simply just there off the fly all the time. Yeah, their willingness to listen is always there, and willingness to comfort is, but that same equivalent level of understanding isn't. And it makes it more difficult. I only know that because, I had this mindset before. And at the time, I mean, I have a vlog that's still up that's titled, well, part of the title was "Do I Deserve This?" It was a while ago. I had the mindset of, it just felt like there was really nobody to talk to. Which, looking back on it, that's not entirely true. Aaron was there, D9 was there, but that's it. That's it. It wasn't much to go off of. At least it didn't feel like it. I don't want people to feel that way. I don't want people to have to go through life thinking that they don't have, like, a peer to turn to who can at least understand where their mind is at, even if they don't understand every detail. And if she was more awake right now, I'm sure Amber would say the same thing. Life is difficult. It can stab you in the butt sometimes, and sometimes when it does that, it's extremely hard to get through. And I get it. I really do. I guess another example of from my end, there was a point when I was settling in to the, like, living on my own at first. It was a while ago, but it's something that I can't just forget. I never showed it, but I did struggle quite a bit. It was tough. Prior to it, I sucked with money. I was really, really, really bad with it. And it's just not something that I could simply just approach, like, without any kind of, like, with every sense of yes. Hold on. Okay, apologies for that. There's a fly rummaging the room and I can't seem to get it. So if that when you see that cross the screen, just ignore it. Back then, I was not just struggling in a sense where, like, financially, but in a way mentally. I didn't like talking to people about any of my problems. I was a very, very big introvert. I didn't even, at the time I'm referring to, I didn't even have a solid pattern for the channel yet. I thought it was going to go nowhere. It was just for the sake of my own humor. I never thought it would get to where it is now. And even with that, thinking back on it, that there are many aspects of an introvert that I showed big time, hardcore. It was tough. It's always, I've lived, after that I lived maybe 3 years of being a hardcore introvert, to the point where eventually I just, aside from work, I would coop myself up in my room. That's it. There were some aspects, every now and then, where this wouldn't be the case, but it was extremely rare. It got to a point where I literally made my bedroom the whole home. You know, aside from using the restroom, that would just be weird, but that's how bad it got for me. I would eat, sleep, watch TV, do office work, like we do now, that's where that cord from, like everything would be done in there. Sure, that's where the whole office thing came from, but I mean, at this point, I'm not really given much of a choice anyway. But in the time span of where I was like that, there's one thing I learned. That was that to many people, including myself at the time, daily life was an extreme struggle. During that time span, coworkers, the separate individual coworkers I had, all of them seemed to have one pattern. They were either people who had dealt with PTSD in the past, part of the LGBTQ community, or they would be people who raised in what's called the system, or they were like, when they were younger, or at the current moment, depending on how old they were, parentless in a way. Many of the friends that I've had in my life, a lot of them had one of those attributes. My school best friend, for example, he was gay, and I respected him for it. The fact that he was open about it too, I definitely gave him respect for that. But there are several people out there who are scared, and not just from that one aspect, it's different scenarios, especially those, the people who I met, coworkers, and sometimes went to the degree of friends, who I had, who either did or like did at that moment or in their past struggle with PTSD, those ones, sometimes all they needed was a shoulder to cry on. even sometimes then, they had a hard time accepting it. Because of fear that they might just get that same treatment that caused them that feeling in the first place. This is not something that I've ever experienced myself. And sometimes, thinking about it, this may sound odd, but sometimes I personally just, I kind of hate it. I hate the fact that I've never experienced stuff like that. But then again, I've also had my own challenges in life that I've already overcome, that push my limits. It's just because something like that probably wouldn't have. I don't know. And that's why I hate it so much, is because I don't know. Because I never experienced it. But that spite makes me at least care for and feel bad for those who did go through it and want to be there for those who do. Even any of you who come across this video at some point in time, that statement is exactly the same. I can at least say this. I haven't gone through every scenario of bad. When you combine me and Amber, or Amber and I, me and Amber, that was right the first time, you come to notice that if one of us can't understand, the other one can. You combine the two of us, and not a single thing has not been gone through. Excuse me. Meaning, every trial in life, either she has gone through it, or I have. If not, both of us. Now, she's obviously asleep, but from both of our hearts combined, you're not alone. Never will be. May seem like it at first, but if it's the case, you just entered a dark tunnel. A tunnel that, for all you know, near the end of it, where there's a lot of light, that light could be the one thing that may keep your path lit for the rest of your life. That I can say for certainty. With that said though, I'm going to leave this here. Please, every word that I've taken into every word I've spoken today, please take all of it into consideration. Think about it. Because every word I say on this channel, everything I do on here, and everything that any of us do, who are part of this nostalgia crew, I guess you could say, all of us do it from our hearts, not from our brains. In case the stupidity on the second videos don't really give that away, but we do care, and we want to make sure no one in the world feels the way that a lot of people I have met, and she has met, do. No one deserves that. No one. Regardless of what's going on. Now that statement is specifically for me. Really, it depends on your own personal opinion. So that one specifically comes from me. ends here. Thanks for watching, guys. I'm gonna head off. Thanks for tuning in. Like the video, sub if you haven't yet, and we'll see you guys later.